I decided to own my ADD when I was struggling to get my GRE done. Right? I wanted to pass it. I wanted to be able to pursue higher education degrees, and I could not pass the GRE. The first time I tried to take the GRE, which was a reflection of my SAT experience, was when I shut down, I would just go to sleep during the SAT. I couldn't function, and I pretty much bombed that. And so I said, okay, I'm gonna put all of my heart and soul into this. I'm gonna study my heart out. And then I couldn't finish the test. I had like 18 questions left on the math section. And at 26, I went and got a neuropsych eval, and the moment the ADD test came out, the questionnaire, and she asked me all these questions, like, yes, 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 these are all issues for me. That was the moment I turned to everyone else and I said, listen, I finally have a name for the things that I've been struggling with, and I'm happy to talk to anyone and everyone about it because no one should go it alone.
Midway through my career, I started to doubt what I'd learned back in grad school, that girls don't get ADHD. It's anxiety or conduct problems or some sort of moral failing. Girls really don't get this condition. It's 10 to 1, 20 to 1. It's been only in the last several decades that people have said, there's probably really not 20 boys to every girl with ADHD. There are more boys than girls, but not with this preponderance that we thought.
ADHD is real. That is a neurobiologic disorder. What that means is that it's really the areas of the brain that are controlling attention, concentration, distractibility, that aren't working in the individuals who have this disorder.
What is it like to be a woman with ADHD? That's a very, very broad question, because ADHD impacts absolutely every aspect of our lives. What are some of the biggest challenges?
Time management and just organizing my day. Like, I want to do 1,000 things during the day, and I can only get so much done, and I have to work that much harder to get it done. Just, you know, getting places on time too is hard. And it impacts your social relationships too with people. They're like, why did you come late again and again? And sometimes you can lose jobs.
It's hard to even talk about. Like, I've been fired from several jobs.
Yeah.
It's so much shame. Yeah, so much shame.
Living with the disorder helped me focus on the disorder more. Helped me understand when I saw these girls and women in my practice that, yes, this is going on and no one's paying attention.
For most people, they're like, oh, no way, you couldn't have this. Mm-hmm. You know, like, you don't do these things. Mm-hmm. It's like, oh, Mary, you're fine. I'm like, actually, I'm really not right now, you know.
I was in elementary school, like, in 1982, 83, 84. Nobody talked about ADHD, especially for girls.
Women kind of fly under the radar because we don't always, anyway, manifest the H part.
Anyone who doesn't look like the stereotypical kid with ADD, ADHD, throwing spitballs in class, running around in circles. I'm like, I didn't look like any of those things. I was super bored in class. I didn't have friends. I just wanted to read.
I was always flying out the window doing anything but this moment, and yet hyperactive, physically active boys would be the first thing to be noticed.
And I feel like we can continue to be invisibilized, we can be erased all the time.
Who gets noticed as having ADHD? The quiet kid in the back of the classroom who can't focus but isn't disrupting anybody? The teacher breathes a sigh of relief. What about the impulsive, active, fidgety, often boy who's making learning pretty tough for everybody? So this is what we call referral bias. You get referred if you're noticeable. This is now the largest study in the world of girls with ADHD over time, and we've learned a tremendous amount.
I had fewer friends when I was younger. I mean, I struggled with my weight, I struggled with depression.
Yeah, I got left out and bullied a lot. Just picked last.
Girls with ADHD have particular problems that boys don't have. For example, girls with ADHD, from our own research, appear to be more likely to be rejected by their girl peers than boys with ADHD.
I've gotten in fights with my friends because I just acted out and I got in a fight. Like, I've lost friends because of it.
College, I'm amazed that I finished college because it was so bad. It's brutal.
It's very brutal. And yeah, it caused me a lot of like anxiety and depression growing up.
The big risk for girls with ADHD that I think our research team was one of the first to uncover in detail is that by middle and late adolescence, with the social rejection, with the continued impulsivity, with the tendency both to get depressed about your life and to still act out against norms, the risk for cutting, self-mutilation, and even suicide attempts is tragically high. We found these shocking statistics. Nearly one girl in four by 19 or 20 with early ADHD had made a serious attempt on her life, and over half were engaging in moderate to severe forms of self-injury, cutting and burning oneself. What percentage of our comparison group had had an unplanned pregnancy? 10%. What percentage of our girls with ADHD? 45%. 4.5 times the risk. So we're focusing on some of the really difficult findings, but ADHD ups the risk for difficult outcomes, but it is not inevitable.
So being diagnosed in my late 40s, it's like, it's not like one light bulb, it's like a whole set of floodlights where you're like, oh, I see. And so then you add in the right medication, I was like,
oh my gosh,
my brain is really slow and steady and I can pay attention. Is this what other people's brains are like?
I think that finding out on my own has really helped a lot of things in my life. A lot of my friends still think I'm very organized and everything, and I'm thinking if they only knew, you know. But I'm not as overwhelmed as I was.
This is a very hopeful disorder in that once it's diagnosed, we know there are lots of things we can do to help you.
It's extremely, extremely therapeutic for people, but especially I find for females to have a place to come in a group setting where they feel understood.
I haven't really noticed much. I think it's because I'm medicated, so.
Where they don't feel judged, where they can learn from each other as well as from the professional that's facilitating the group how to work with their ADHD.
If you had just one piece of wisdom to offer to a girl that's maybe just starting to learn that she might have ADD, what kind of advice would you give?
Like, don't be afraid to tell people because it's not something you should be like ashamed of.
So for me, I'm medicated and it's a blessing. I love my medicine.
We think that treating kids with ADHD from early ages is going to be preventive. We find the best results consistently when the right medicines are paired with the behavioral or family or school or cognitive behavioral treatments so that you get symptom reduction and the building of competence.
One program doesn't fit all. We need to tailor these programs to where our patients are, what their primary target symptoms or target problems are right now, and then work with them as they move along and as they move on.
My goal is to really take responsibility for the challenges that I have, like as if I had a wheelchair. So I have to make sure there's ramps. I have to make sure there's someone who can help me. And so you may not see that, but I've set up all these things in place. And that's the freedom it gives, like, oh, maybe I can do some of these things I didn't think I could do because I now put those ramps up that help me get up the stairs.
Many of our girls with ADHD have overcome a lot of their symptoms. Many of them are doing well in relationships and on the job. We're scouring our data now to look at the factors that predict resilience.
As long as you figure out your system for how to function in the job that you have or to do what you love, you'll be able to offer everything you have to the world. But if you don't figure out your system and you try other people's systems and it doesn't work for you, but you keep trying, that's not gonna work. You have to figure out what works for you.